In this episode, I'll show you four simple modifications you can make to your CR10 Mini. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of my Patreon supporters. The first mod I tried was the CR10 spool holder frame mount by user Churzer on Thingiverse. I printed that on my CR10 and then I took the mount off my CR10 Mini. The CR10 came with these spare parts, which are T-nuts and screws, and this bracket seemed to be designed perfectly for them because the screws fit in the holes with just enough length for the T-nuts. So I installed those, both of them, and then the bracket slides into the slot. And then you tighten them with the thumb screws like you did on the original CR10 mount. Now these are a little tight and hard to do with the finger, but it's got a screw head, Phillips head, so I just tightened it with a screwdriver. And this seemed pretty solid at the time anyway. And I actually had mounted this on my CR10 full size. But then I realized I'm gonna put an adjustment knob on this thing, so this is gonna get in the way. So I found another spot I wanted to try, and that's in the back of the CR10 Mini. And once I got it mounted, I wasn't happy with how tight it was. And that's when I thought, you know what? I could just drill these out and put T-nuts in directly. So I drilled out the bracket and then found some shorter screws. The other ones were a little too long. These were still too long, but added a couple washers and then it worked. So I put the T-nuts on the end of those screws and then I mounted just this bracket, no 3D print, to the back of the printer. And I slid it in place, tightened it up, and this thing seemed to be working really well. It seemed really solid. So once that was in place, I actually ended up moving this in a little bit more towards the center of the printer. But once I had that, this looked really good. The spool holder post was a little bit too big. I've had a few spools that didn't fit. And I found this one from John Jay on Thingiverse. So I printed it out and it mounted perfectly to the existing CR10 bracket. And all the threads printed beautifully. And this was at a 0.3 layer height. I did this on my Prusa MK2S. So once that was there, the nice red contrasting color, I was ready to move on to the next mod. And I found this filament guide by user Greg191134. This thing turned out to be so amazing how well it mounted. It guides the filament in away from the threaded rod, and it also holds the wiring. And here's the one that I made. Now, it printed very simple at a 0.3 layer height. I did that on the CR10. But you can see there's a lip that's inside this thing underneath. And then it just pushes on into place. I thought the screws held it on, but it didn't. You just push it on at an angle and then just keep working it until it snaps over the top of the screw heads. And once it snaps in, it's on there. You can take it back off, but it's on there really good. And then it's got a nice zigzag here to hold the filament. This is a great design. And then the clip itself holds the wiring for the hot end. So once that was in place, that was an easy fix. I moved on to the next one. I like the single Z-axis threaded rod. It makes it easier to move. And I found this knob by user Bash on Thingiverse. So I printed it out and it also prints a little bracket that goes around it. So you got to replace the existing bracket at the top of the threaded rod and then put on this new one that has a bigger hole, a bigger gap for the knob. So it uses the same screws and they fit in perfectly. I just tightened it down both sides and it fit a little tight, but that's perfect. So once it fit in, then I screwed the knob on to the threaded rod. And I wanted this to fit tight enough, so I grabbed the pliers and just held it so I could get the knob tight. But mostly you're going to be turning it away so it lifts the thing up or down and gravity is going to help you. So there isn't a lot of force on this, but it really worked well and makes it so easy to lift this thing up, like if I want to push filament through quickly or want to get it away from a print. The final item is the CR10 knob for adjusting the bed. I found this one by Dan Bear on Thingiverse. I really like these things on my TiVo Tornado. So I printed one out, that's the black one, but I could not get the knob to fit in. So I went back to Simplify 3D, and this time I printed it at 102%. I found that when something doesn't fit right, just bump it up 2%, and typically that works. So I did that, and here's the rest of the settings. I did a 0.3 layer height, 30% fill. I did this on my Prusa MK2S at pretty standard PLA temperatures. I did it at a 60 millimeters per second. And when I sliced it, it said it would only take 33 minutes to print a knob, which is awesome 5.5 meters of plastic. So I printed one out. The 102% seemed to work great. The CR10 knob pressed right in place, nice and tight. Here's the finished design. I love the red on black color scheme, and this is just a great printer and I love using it. So this just makes it better. If you like this type of work, maybe check out some of my other videos that are popping up here. If you want to help support the channel, $1 a month to Patreon. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time.